Hello friends, I hope you guys are doing well. I recently got 3 sets of paint from Jen Crafts to try out and review. In my last videos, I tried out their gouache and watercolor sets. So today, I'm going to try out their acrylic paint set. This set came with a beautiful box that has 24 tubes, and each tube has 22 ml of paint. You can find the information of this company on the side of the box, and they also include a color chart for this paint set. Inside of this box, there are 3 trays that hold the paint tubes, and each tray has 8 tubes of paint. First thing I noticed that this paint set has a very good selection of colors. So now I'm going to make some swatches to see how the colors look on paper, so the paint doesn't feel too thick or thin, and it is pretty easy to squeeze out from the tube. So here I'm using a flat brush to spread out the paint that I just put on paper, and I also mix some water to the paint to see how the paint works when adding water to it. The colors in this paint set are so vibrant and look beautiful on paper so far. I also noticed that they dry really quick after apply on paper. So if you guys are interested in checking out this acrylic paint set, I do have a link in the video description box down below, along with other things that I use in this video for you if you need them. And this is how the paints look when they dry. The colors are so rich and vibrant, and I'm really excited to try out this paint set on a painting. So next, I'm going to make a new painting in my sketchbook. I'm making this painting as a tutorial, so please feel free to paint this if you like. The reference photo for today's painting is from unplush.com, and I will have links for everything that I use in the video description box down below for you if you need them. So here I'm using washi tape to divide the part between the water and the sky. So here I have blue, white, yellow, and red. And I'm using a 3/4 inch flat brush for this. So now I'm going to mix a blue color for the sky. And I'm going to start from the top of the painting. Then I blend it down to about halfway of the painting. Next, I mix yellow and white together, and I blend it into the blue. Then I add in some red, and I also blend it with the yellow and white. And you can see here, I'm painting on top of the tape in the middle, so that when I remove the tape later, I will have a straight and clean edge. So now I'm mixing a reddish purple to paint the bottom part of the sky. Then I mix yellow and white to paint the sun and the sunlight. I also mix a peach pink color from red, yellow, and white together to paint the middle part of the sky. Now I'm adding another layer of red purple to the bottom part of the sky. Then I use white to paint the middle part of the sun. For the sunlight, I add some yellow to white. So now I'm painting the clouds using Prussian blue mixed with red, and I use a filbert brush for this. Here you can see that I only use the tip of this brush to apply a very light pressure on my painting. And as I move closer to the sun, I just add more red to the paint mixture to paint the clouds because of the sunlight is reflecting on the cloud. So now I use orange color for the clouds that are right above the sun. So here I'm just picking up some paint to make a smooth transition between the colors, and then I'm just continue painting the sun and the sunlight. So now I'm using a dark purple to paint the rest of the cloud. And for this, I turn my brush so I can make thinner strokes. So now I'm removing the tape in the middle because the top part of the sky is done. And I also add another piece of tape, but this time it will cover part of the sky and the sun. Next, I'm painting the water using all the colors that I painted the sky above, because the sky is reflecting on the water. And this is just the base layers. I still need to add more details on top of these layers later. So now I go back to the top part of the painting to paint the highlights of the clouds, and I'm using a reddish pink and a number 8 round brush for this. Then I use a dark purple to paint some of the shadows for the clouds. Next, I add the details for the water, and I'm using a small flat brush for this. Then I switch to a number 8 rail brush and I continue painting the water. The color that I'm painting now, I mix from dark blue, red, and black. And I'm just painting the shadow part of the water with this color. Next, I add yellow mixed with white to paint the reflection of the sun. Then I mix a light pink color to add to the highlights of the water. So for the rest of this painting, I will continue adding more details of the highlights and shadows for the water until I'm done. And now I'm removing the tape in the middle so I can paint the rest of the reflection on the water. Thank you. So now we are done with this painting. Next, I wait for all the paint to dry, and I carefully remove all the washi tape around the painting. And here is the closer look of the final painting. I'm very happy with how it turned out, and I had a lot of fun using this acrylic pen set. So thank you, Tin Crabs, again for sending me your art supplies, and thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoy this video and find it helpful. I wish you a beautiful day, and I hope to see you again in my next video. Bye.